So what's the AOL view on video? Does it take over? Is that the way you do top of the funnel branding demand creation, or can you do it with video? Destination a little bit. It was a really interesting slide that was on the first demonstration. It said the third-party sites do much better than the OEM sites. Does it annoy you that you can't get people to Ford.com as easily as you can get them to AOL or in the network that Eric and the other guys are doing? No. Do you care whether they come to that Ford site?
I could care less if I have zero visitors on Ford.com as long as the message is getting out there. There's lots of places where people are going to consume content. If you're consuming available content about four products on AOL, MSN, Redmix, right? That's fine with me. I think we need to think about our messages and our content being more portable. It's not always just about being able to click through the Ford.com. We want to make our content a little more comfortable.
So what is it about an OEM site? It's kind of logical that, is it less credible? Is that why they don't go? Is it the comparison that they have to do? I mean, in a perfect world, you wouldn't have to advertise. People know Ford, they're getting ready to buy a car. They should just go to the Ford site and then go to the Toyota site and make a decision and no advertiser at all.
I think Jane Parker and Reese have the same lately, but you can trust OEM sites for vehicle information, packaging and pricing and stuff the OEM should know about. They trust their great sites for the independent information. And that's always going to be the case, right? If they come to the OEM site, they're going to do that content as accurately as possible, right? That's why you see things like payment calculators and tell you how much it's going to cost a month and things like that. But we also have a role in taking that rich content we produce on Ford.com and making it portable, getting it out there so you can have that rich experience as well. So the nice thing about a brand like Ford that has the product quality and the product attributes, it doesn't matter where you interact with us, right? We have great products for you that we're at.
Don't care if you ever get an ad clicked?
Care, yeah, but that's not the ultimate metric. I think the average click-through rate's less than 0.01%. But that's not the ultimate metric. I think very few people are going to go from reading their mail or reading the news story to flipping through and researching a comment, right? But that doesn't mean that matters an effect on them. I think we just need to refine our models on how we measure the effect of it then.
I have to believe that you've been in a ton of meetings where someone has said, why can't the Ford site do it for us? Why do we have to advertise? Can't we get to a future that's different? So I get that you get it. Obviously, this is a world you live in, but aren't there a bunch of guys back at headquarters who are going, can't we use this internet to change it?
You mean get more people to our website?
Just change the whole mix of not having to advertise?
No, we still need to bring people to the store, and that's the store. We have 7 million people a month on Ford.com, and we're the highest traffic site, but it's not because we're running a bunch of direct response video and we're banner advertising on the site. It's because people are getting our message and they're finding their way to Ford.com. Most of the traffic to Ford.com is indirect. It's not direct from
ad ads. The rest of us talk about it a little bit. I mean, if you could figure out how the OEM sites are more